Welcome to my new series called Talk Tech with Tiff, where I am sitting down with industry professionals to hear about their career journeys and current roles. I created this series to hear from people who are established in the tech industry so that we can all learn what these individuals do in their day-to-day jobs and the type of opportunities that are out there. Okay, let's get started. Today, I'm sitting here with AK, who is a software engineer at Shopify. Hi, AK.
Hi, Tiff.
How's it going?
Pretty good. Yourself?
It's going good. I'm trying to stay warm with the weather, but other than that, good.
Nice, nice. Same. It's pretty brutal out here.
I know. Well, I'm really excited to have you on today because there are a lot of people who watch these videos who want to become essentially what you do, a software developer or software engineer. So I know there's going to be, I have a lot of questions here for you. But before we really get into it, tell me a little bit about your current role as a software engineer at Shopify.
So I'm a backend developer, so I guess focus on the backend. So a lot of the work I do is related to a lot of the API development at Shopify. So that's like connecting about the different services between, Shopify and like all this multiple different like avenues of sales.
Yeah, nice. And you've been there for just about 2 years, you said, right?
Yes, a year and 8 months.
And are you still? Do you feel like you're still learning something new every day?
Well, of course, like I feel. Yeah, so many amazing people that you get to meet every day. So it's like you cannot not learn something new every day. It's like different problems. Every day is kind of like something new, which is the reason why I love the place too. Because it's like it's not the same thing every day. It's not like the same. Like there's no set process you got to follow every day. It's kind of like, what's going to happen today?
Yeah, that's such a great way too because it keeps your job super interesting. And then you're also continuing to level up your skills.
Yeah, yep.
That's awesome. So I know you are a computer engineering graduate. How did you know software engineering was what you wanted to pursue?
Pretty funny story actually about this, right? So right up until applying for university, I was going to be an architect. So like that was kind of like my goal like for the past like 3 years of high school. It's like, oh, I'm going to school to be an architect, right? And literally the day I was like looking to school to apply, my dad and I were just talking. I was like, oh, consider computer engineering, like, you know, you're into this kind of stuff anyway, like, and then we're just talking about how, like, where the future was kind of moving towards. Yeah. So it was like, this is actually, like, a great idea, and also there are multiple ways you can use your love for design, which I kind of loved as well, for architecture, into computer engineering, computer science. So I was like, okay, why not? And I ended up applying just for engineering in general.
Okay.
With the mindset of, you know, where, like, let me see, where that's going to go. And then eventually I was like, yeah, it was a no-brainer at that point. Wow. After I kind of did my research.
Wow. So when you started your engineering degree and you were in engineering in general, did you have, leading up to that or even in your first year of engineering, did you have prior coding experience or was this completely new as you went along with it?
It was pretty new. Like I had friends who had been coding for the past 3 years, 4 years, like had personal projects. I went there like knowing like, I'd done very, very, very basic work. So it was everything was new to me, like learning everything every day.
Yeah. But you never look back. You're never like, oh, I wish I would have gone the architecture route.
I don't because I don't think it's gone. You know, I still think I can find ways to, you know, get involved in that field. And yeah, I still plan to though. So,
we'll see. Yeah, that's one of the best things about, coding in general and that skill because you can apply it to any industry and whether it's to start your own company or move to a company where it's focusing on design or architecture or whatever it is, you can do it with coding.
Yep. Not like I tell a lot of my friends about this too. Like I have a lot of friends who study different things, whether it was law, whether it was like chemical engineering, who kind of like just end up switching over. Yeah. And I'm like, you could still find a place within the chemistry industry.
Yes.
With the tech background. Mm-hmm. So it's like, it's very versatile like that. And
I agree. It is. It's really cool. I think everyone should learn how to code because it's just such a powerful skill. Not necessarily continue their career that way, but just at the very basic level, like we learn math or science or anything like that. But so I get asked a lot on my channel by my subscribers, how does one get experience before landing your first job? So you're in school. How do you gain that first experience?
I feel, like I said, multiple different ways usually, right? I guess the most common is usually like internships. Mm-hmm. But they show internships that sort of like it's these days with like big tech companies, it's like it's, to get even into these companies, a whole like it's like you're applying to the it's like you're applying for a new grad role anyway, it right? So I guess the kind of way I went about it was because I studied computer engineering, so my work wasn't necessarily focused exactly on like comp sci, right? Yeah. So it was pretty like broad, and the amount of things I did was very like, well, I wasn't just software focused. So I ended up like during my spare time, I always kind of worked on a project, side projects, like I love hackathons. Like I did a lot of hackathons. Like I drove to New Jersey like a for a hackathon. I had so many fun stories, which was like fun memories I look back on too as well too. So it was those two were like pretty big ones too. And I attempted startups with friends too, like some are still going on to today, some sadly have fallen off too. And yeah, just a lot of personal development on your side.
Yeah.
I feel that's the biggest thing. Like you cannot rely solely on like the work you're doing from school.
It's so true. And when you were building, you mentioned building different kind of side projects. Were those projects things that you were passionate about, or what? How did you decide on what projects to build?
I feel it was initially more like what interested me. Like, I guess the passion came later, but it was more about like, oh, how does this work? You know, like I'm kind of curious how, like, how does the website do this, or how does my phone do this? Like, how can I get an app that does this thing, right?
Yeah.
So like that kind of interest and that like learning, that peak of interest in this particular software was what kind of dragged me to find out how it worked. Yeah. Then after that, you kind of figure out exactly what field, like, you know, you're passionate in, because I guess there are a billion different like parts that you can go into. So
yeah, exactly. Going back to hackathons a bit, I want to touch on this because I've actually never been to a hackathon, and it's mainly because, well, not now, but when I was first starting out, they seem so intimidating, and everyone who's been is like, no, Tiff, it's fine, just go. And I'm like, so what was your experience like going to your first hackathon? Is it really as intimidating as I feel like it would be?
I'm trying to think back what my first one was. Let's see. I think my first one was actually at Queens, I guess, which was my university. Yep. So I feel that was different because I guess it was I was just kind of like still at school.
Mm-hmm.
So, but I do understand the intimidation in there because it's like you hear the project we're working on, like, and you're like, oh, these are industry level projects, right? Yeah. Like I couldn't imagine myself building this. Like when I'm just trying to build a website, I did this simple, what's the weather, you know? And you have people like doing this complex project with the AI and machine learning. It's like, I can see the intimidation there.
Yeah.
But I feel it's more about kind of just, like I said before, what interests you? You know, when you start off with like if you start something off really hard, like you lose interest because it's hard, right? If you start with something like you're more really into, like more something very like, you know, just interests you, then the passion would grow from there, you know?
Exactly. I totally agree. And okay, so you've been to a bunch of hackathons, it sounds like. What is there a memory that stands out, like one that was really fun, a hackathon that stands out to you?
Yeah, that's a big one, right? So there's a whole backstory to it, right? So it's I don't know, like it's probably like what 20, I don't know, some 20, maybe 2018 November, like middle winter, right? It was cold out, like I had plans for it was Princeton's University Hackathon.
Wow.
Right? My friend and I were initially gonna go, then we canceled, and then last minute at like 6 p.m., which was already way too late, he hit me up, was like, okay, you still want to go for this? And I was like, you know, why not? So at like 6 p.m. we drive to New Jersey, like just pick our things up and just drive up there and like going through like icy roads, literally.
Oh my goodness.
And then we kind of get there and then, like, you know what? So let's just do what we can. We end up like, sleeping in the car that night, actually.
Wow.
And then the next day we just kind of rented a motel and just kind of like hacked away because we just didn't want to be on campus. I don't know why. I can't remember why though. We just want to be on campus.
Yeah.
It was pretty funny because we just had a whole Harry Potter marathon playing while we just kind of hacked away for like a whole day and a half.
Wow.
And then the best part was we ended up winning a hackathon, which kind of just was icing on the cake, literally, because, and everyone just kind of loved our project too, which is like the best thing. It made everything just more worth it. It was very like spontaneous. And then it was like, oh, shit, like we actually went through this. Like we drove, like, how many hours was it? Six or so? We drove up there and then we actually kind of ended up bringing something back. So it was pretty fulfilling though. So
that is. And I love how too, it was the things you went through to get there, you know, from the icy roads to sleeping in your car and then to ending up winning it when you weren't even going to go.
Yeah, literally. It was that the day of, we kind of just like, just too tired. Let's just not do this anymore. And just like 6 p.m. We got there like what, 1 a.m. or something.
Wow. Wow. Congratulations, by the way. That's really cool.
thanks.
So what to expect for people who are still in school or considering a career in software engineering, what to expect your first few weeks on the job? Is it, because I think some people get nervous that it's going to be, the first day is you're going to build the next Facebook or something. Like, what is it actually like the first few weeks?
I feel people expect to know what they're going to do.
Yeah.
I feel a lot, especially if you're hired off out of university, like, they know you don't know. Like,
yeah.
You clearly don't know what, you know, you can't just pull up the next day and, like, start coding for them, right?
Yeah.
I feel sort of like they kind of hire you knowing that you can learn. At least that's what Shopify does anyway. They hire learners, people that are trying to grow.
Yeah.
Right? So the first month or so for me, it was literally just learning Shopify tools and services. Like, literally, I didn't do anything professional, any, like, actual work contributing to actual Shopify's services up until the second month.
Yeah.
The first month was just straight, like, learning, like, Ruby on Rails, like, learning how to develop in Shopify, like, learning the different tools and services and how to maneuver my way around the code base.
Yeah.
So it was very, like, it took the time out, a whole month. That's a whole month, right? And I got paid for that whole month too, right?
Yeah.
So to actually just, let's get him actually comfortable with the work he's going to do.
Yeah.
And then moving on, you can like slowly get let in. So I feel like the fear of like, oh, I'm going to go in there, I'm not going to perform off the first month. It's like, it's just most companies anyway, like would put in the work to actually teach you before they actually like throw you in the deep end.
Yeah. I think most good companies.
Yeah, that's the right word.
Yeah,
keyword.
Yeah. Good companies. Yeah, I heard somewhere, I don't know if this is true or not, but I heard somewhere that on average, and I guess this depends on how senior a person is, but on average it takes 3 months for a person to get familiarized with a code base. And I know that can vary based on the size and all that, but it makes sense. Like a big, big code base, it takes time.
No, definitely. I've been Shopify for like a year and 8 months. I'm definitely not fully.
Yeah,
I mean, because Shopify, so yeah, it's just, it's yeah. It's
huge.
It kind of depends what you're working on, right? If your sole project is on that code base, then yeah, it could take.
So long.
Yeah, it takes quite a while.
Exactly. But you get more comfortable in it.
Yeah, definitely. Like, the more you work in it, the more you kind of.
Yeah.
Ease into it.
Well, speaking of that, you know, getting more comfortable and all that, what do you do when you get stuck on a problem? Do you have someone, do you have kind of a routine? You know, for example, I Google and then I talk to my rubber doc and then I go talk to someone. Or what's your problem solving process?
What is mine? Let's see. I feel like I'm a music guy. I don't know. I don't usually code with music, but yeah. I don't know when I want like some kind of like just, it's kind of reset. I just kind of just step away and kind of play something and then just kind of like listen to that for a minute and then go back to the problem. Like that's just one of the many, I guess. Like having a rubber duck key is also like very nice to just, you know, someone talk to kind of help you get past a problem as well. But I don't know. My go-to is usually just kind of, I just do something else.
Yeah.
Because most times if I spend like, it's 2 hours on a problem and I can't figure it out, the best thing there is just kind of like, do something else.
I know. I totally agree.
Like I have projects where like, oh, I'm working on an issue and I'm like, I just say, okay, tell my team, I'm gonna do something completely different for the next day. Just kind of like reset.
Yeah, exactly. You know? But it's easier. I don't know if it's just, maybe it's just me, but it's easier said than done. I often find myself like knowing that's what I should do, but I'm so frustrated. I'm like, I just need one more hour and I'm going to get it. And then it's like, Tiff, if you had just stepped away, gone for a walk,
no,
it would
have
been okay.
100%.
You know?
You just need that like, reset. That's reset sometimes.
Yeah. Yeah. I like that. The music thing. For me, I'm a walk person. You can just go for walks and like walk it out.
And I love walking too. I don't know. I've never tried it in between projects usually, but like, you know, I love walking as well. It's a big thing for
head clearer.
Definitely.
I agree. How do you keep up? So as you know, tech is changing so quickly and different frameworks and languages are coming out or different updates to them. So how do you keep up with the ever-changing tech industry or do you?
I'll say a lot of blogs. Like, I feel like maybe a lot of people say that too. It's like a lot of blogs. I use Twitter a lot too.
Mm.
So I'll say just kind of have like for a lot of blogs, kind of just like every day is like news articles, kind of just seeing what is new.
Yeah.
But actually keep in touch, like keeping updated, like with my skill level. It's like, it definitely gets tough because I guess everything changes. Like in the past 5 years, like so many things, new technologies have come out that it's kind of hard to say, okay, I'm keeping myself to the top level of my industry.
Yeah.
I don't know. I feel like I just try the best I can, right? If I'm focusing this, I'm working on like, I don't know, GraphQL, just kind of like straight keep working on that thing and getting better the more updates come out. Mm-hmm. It's kind of focused on one thing. If you try to like do everything,
yeah,
it's kind of like you kind of get lost, right?
Exactly. Focusing on certain things versus trying to, what is the word? Become a generalist and focus on everything.
Yeah. I don't know. There's a model that I think it's called a T model, something like that, where like you learn a little bit of everything. It's going to have your base like knowledge, mm-hmm. and then you kind of pick what exactly you want to focus on, and then you go straight for that
too. I like that, and it's so true. I find with many careers in tech and I think software engineering as well, like you kind of, when you're learning, you learn a little bit about everything, and then as you grow, you realize what area you want to specialize in as you continue to have experiences.
Yeah, no, definitely, and you can always switch after it too anyway.
Exactly, which is such a good thing, because then you don't feel like you're committed to one area forever.
Yeah, and I started off as more in the front end focus, like that was a lot of the work I did.
Yeah,
because I was like more interested by like the websites and web apps, yeah. and whatnot, and then eventually, literally, like the last year of university, I switched to more backend. Mm-hmm. And then eventually, I'm going to try out production engineering soon, too.
So. Wow, good for you. That's really cool. Yeah. So how did you know? I'm just really curious. So you went from frontend to more backend things. How did you know it was something you wanted to try? Or was it just through experience?
I started building a lot of projects by myself, right? Mm-hmm. And usually, I guess to build a whole project, kind of need a whole flow of like going from like how it looks, yeah. how it actually functions on the back, and then like, you know, how it's gonna like scale, right? So it's after doing a little bit of that, like focusing mainly on the front end, I was like, I actually want to get better in the back and actually build projects solely back end focused without necessarily a front end. You know, it's kind of strengthen that skill specifically. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. I think this kind of goes back to the whole team model, right? Where I'm trying to learn a little bit of each thing per se.
Yeah.
And then kind of decide. I don't feel like I've decided right now.
Yeah.
Like, even though I've been doing back for the past 2 years, I don't feel like I've actually decided what exactly I want to focus on, though.
I think that's a good place to be, because that means you're open-minded and just continuing to try out new things.
Yeah, definitely. Definitely. Yeah. Gonna have to.
Exactly. And it's still, you know, there's still so much time.
I guess I'm pretty young, so I guess,
got some time. Exactly. So what would you tell, last question I have for you. What would you tell your younger self? What advice would you give to your younger self?
Let's see. Interesting. So much, quite a lot, I guess. I don't know. Just keep trying things, man. Like life's, life's short, as they say. But I don't know. Keep exploring. There's so much thing to, like, start early. You know, don't get too comfortable.
Yeah,
you know,
I like that.
I feel like that's where I'm at right now. It's like, I guess I wasn't comfortable back then, but, like, I was kind of set on, I'm going to do this one thing. And I just kind of, like, close out all my other options. Right, but like, just if I told myself, you know what, like I'm young now, let me just try a bit of everything, whether it's like sports, whether it's like different like what's it called, different careers, not necessarily careers, but like different like industries, kind of understand a little bit of both. Like right now, I'm like, I try my best to kind of like learn a bit of things out there, not necessarily like the whole, like, not obviously I'm not like going to the career, but like learn a bit about politics, a bit about like finance, like just kind of have those little skills, and everyone's useful as well too. So
exactly, I like that. Stay curious.
Exactly, that's a awesome. Nice, wait, look at it. Yeah,
yeah. AK, it's been really awesome to sit down and chat with you. I know I gained a lot from just sitting here, and I could continue this conversation for a long time. So thank you so much.
Likewise, thank you for having me.
Awesome, thank you.